Next is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 18. Given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Recorded on October 12, 1973, in Bombay, India.
Jyotisham api tad jyoti tamasa paramuchyate jnanam 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 gamyam iti sarvasya vistitam. Jyoti, jyoti means light. There are different types of light. There is lamp, there is candle, there is electric bulb. The power also, they have different powers. 100 powers, 50 powers, 25. There are different grades of jyoti. But there is supreme jyoti. Just like this moon, this night is full moon. This moon has got its illumination. But where from this illumination comes? It comes from the sun sign. The sun sign is reflected on the moon, and the moon has become illuminating source. Just like in a mirror, when there is reflection of the sun sign, the mirror can also reflect another dark place. Not independently. Everyone, in childhood, everyone has played with a mirror. Just put a mirror in front of the sun sign, and the reflection is there, and you can pass on the reflection in the darkest place, and it will be in you. Have you got experience? Similarly, neither the mirror has got reflection, neither the dark place can be illuminated by the mirror. But when the sun sign is there on the mirror acts as illuminating agent, and it dissipates the darkness of a corner. The sun sign is the source of all light. In the material world, you have got experience with sun sign, jyoti, prakash. But where from the sun sign comes? Sun sign is also reflection of another jyoti or illumination. That illumination is called Brahma jyoti. And where from that Brahma jyoti emanates? That emanates from Krishna. Just like the sun sign is emanation from the sun glow, and the sun glow is fiery, illuminated on account of the persons within the sun glow. They have got some bodily rays. That rays is emanating from their body. Therefore the whole sun planet looks like fiery planet. And from there, the illumination comes, and it is reflecting on the moon. And the moon is illuminating the whole dark night. This is called Purnima. The one is borrowing the illumination from the other, but there is the supreme source of illumination, that is Krishna. That is confirmed in the Brahman Samhita. Jasya praha prabhavato jagadanna kuti. Just from her, the bodily rays of Krishna being illuminated, in that illumination, which is called Brahma Jyoti, there are innumerable Vaikuntha planets. The Vaikuntha planets are self-illuminated. Therefore, in the spiritual world, there is no darkness. Tamasa para, that which is said here, that tad jyotis tamasa param uchyate. The spiritual world is beyond this material world. This material world is called tama. Tama means darkness, just like this night. It is darkness. Why it is darkness? By nature it is dark. Simply by the sunshine, moonshine, electricity, we keep it brightened for some time. Otherwise, by nature it is darkness. Similarly, there is another word. Parastasmatu bhava anya. Another cosmic manifestation, spiritual cosmic manifestation, where there is no need of sunshine. Natatra bhasayati surya, na sasanka na pavu. There is no need of sunshine, there is no need of moonshine, as here in this darkness, material world, there is arrangement by God to illuminate the darkness of this world. There is sun, there is moon, there is electricity, there is fire. But in the spiritual world, which is tamasa para, which is beyond this darkness of this material world, there is jyoti. Therefore here it is said, jyotisham apim tad jyoti param. There are different kinds of illumination, sunshine, moonshine, electricity, fire. But that jyoti, which is directly emanating from Krishna's body, that is the real jyoti. So, on account of Krishna's bodily rays, the whole creation is coming out. That is Krishna's inconsumable power, Brahma Jyoti. Janmadasya jataha, athāta Brahma Jyāna, in the Vedānta Sutra, we have to inquire about that Param Jyoti, Brahma Jyoti. And from that Param Jyoti, everything is coming out. Just like from the sunshine, what is this material world? This material world is resting on the sunshine. Because the sunshine is there, therefore all the planets are rotating. There is a small machine, as soon as it is heated, within that machine the balls begin to rotate. Similarly, the certain temperature of the sunshine, the whole planetary system is rotating on the orbit on account of the sunshine. This is scientific reality. And because there is sunshine, there is vegetation, there is water, there is rainfall, and from the rainfall there is agricultural products. As sunshine is the cause of all material variegatedness, similarly, this sunshine is also due to the Brahma Jyoti. The sunshine, jat chakshuresha savita satanagrahana, the sun is described in the Brahma Samhita, and the eyes for all the planets. Jat chakshuresha Esa sakalam grahanam chakshu. The sun is the actual eyes for all the planets, because unless there is sunshine, you cannot see. We are very much proud of our eyes. Sometimes we challenge, can you show me God? But he does not think that what power his eyes have got. It is completely dependent on the sunshine. If there is no sunshine, his so-called eyes are useless. Still with that useless eyes, he wants to see God. You see, can you show me God? I am not seeing God. God cannot be seen. Therefore I don't believe in God. But he does not think that what power he has got to see. It is only dependent on sunshine. Not only this planet, all the planets. Unless there is sunshine, because it is darkness. This material world is simply darkness. Tamasi ma jyotirgamo. The Vedic instruction is, don't keep yourself in this darkness of material world. Come out to the spiritual world, jyotirgamo. The people do not think of their imperfectness of the senses, how the senses working dependent on the laws of material nature. Instead, one is very proud of his senses, especially of the eyes, adhokhi. Everything dependent on his eyes, although his eyes are completely useless without being helped by the light of the sun. So actually, these eyes are useless. The eyes of the eyes is the sun. Jatyaksharesa savita sakalam grahana. Every planetary system, there are many millions and trillions of living entities. They can see only when there is sunrise. This Gayatri mantra is therefore offering prayer to the Savita. Om Bhurgava Sa Tat Savitu Varannam Varga Devasa Dhimai. Sunshine. So sunshine is, but there are many suns, not only one sun. And there are many universes. Jasya Prabha Prabhupatu Jagadanna Koti. Koti means innumerable. Numberless universes. And in each and every universe, there is sunshine. So this sunshine is reflection of the Brahma Jyoti. Jasya Prabha Prabhupatu. When this bodily rays, shining rays of Krishna is there, then all these universes are generated. The universes are also generated. In another place, Jasaika Nishasita Kalama Thavalamba Jivanti Loma Vilaja Jagadandanatha. Jagadandanatha. Jagadandanath means, Jagadanda means universe. Each universe has a principal living being, that is Lord Brahma. So there are many innumerable Brahmagas, innumerable Shivas, innumerable suns, innumerable moons. Then there are innumerable universes. And each and every universe, there are innumerable planets. Jasya Prabha Prabhupatu Jagadanna Koti. Koti Su. Asesa Vasudhadi. Vasudha means this planet. Vibhuti Vindam. Each planet has got different atmosphere. Therefore these people, they cannot understand what is the atmosphere. They understand. Some scientists, they say the atmosphere in the moon planet is 200 degrees below zero. So, there are different sort of scientists' opinion. But according to Vedic literature, you understand that there are innumerable planets and one of the planet is the moon planet. Nakhatranam aham sashi. Nakhatranam, among the stars and planets. Krishna says, I am the moon. So Jyotisham api jyoti, tamasapara. So this jyoti, this illumination, is beyond this material world. And because there is illumination, that illumination is reflected in the material world. You will find the reflection, bluish reflection in the sky. It means that Brahma Jyoti is bluish because it is coming out from the blue body of Krishna. Therefore it is bluish. We see the sky bluish, and in darkness we see, although it is darkness, there is some brightness in the sky. Although the sky is everywhere, but the covering is sometimes covered by different types of material elements, and that Brahma Jyoti is penetrating through the covers and little reflection we can see in the sky. Therefore, here it is said, Jyotisham api tat jyoti samasapara uchyate jnanam geyam jnanagammam iti sarvasya adhisthitam. Adhisthitam. Krishna is situated in everyone's heart. Actually, he is knowledge and he is the object of knowledge, geyam. And one should try to understand Krishna. Jnanam geyam jnanagammam. And he is in everyone's heart. Ishara sarvabhutanam hridayeshu arjuna tishtati. Simply, we have to know the process, how to know him. That is explained already. We have discussed. Amanittam avgambittam ahimsa khanti adhamam acharyopasanam indriya vinigraham bhakti yoga mansa vyabhicharini bhakti yogena. These things are already discussed. So, human life is meant for understanding this. Asatam brahma. These are all brahma subjects. They are not material subject matter. Tattva-bhadanti-tattva-vidas-tattvam. Just jnana-madhyam. This Vedic civilization is meant for Brahma realization. Therefore, we have got so many Vedic literature. Bhagavad Gita is only a part, ABCD, the first book of spiritual knowledge. Still, people are so degraded that they cannot understand even Bhagavad Gita. The ABCD. What they will understand? Other things. Their education is so poor and they are so unfortunate that in Bhagavad Gita, which Krishna left behind him, Krishna was present 5,000 years ago on this planet, and just to benefit us, he left his instruction, Bhagavad Gita. Arjuna did not require the instruction of Bhagavad Gita. He was already enlightened. But he presented himself as a fool just to induce the Lord to speak on Bhagavad Gita. And it is noted by Vyasadeva, Vedavyas, in the Mahabharata, so that people may take advantage of the instruction of the Supreme Personality, the Lord. Everything is there. What is this Brahma Jyoti? What is this material world? What is the spiritual world? What is our object of life? What we should know? But we are because we are so much influenced by the material world, especially in this age of Kali, the age of misunderstanding and quarreling, that people are mandar sumandha matayo mandu bhagda dipantita prayana alpaya yusa kalavasmi vivejana. This age that life is very short, span of life is very short, and mandha, all bad, then good men, mandha, and even there are so-called good men, they have got their own process of knowledge, the speculative process, godless. The main basic principle of speculative process is to avoid Krishna, to avoid God. There are so many commentaries on Bhagavad Gita to make Krishna need. Mental speculation. Somebody is saying that in the Bhagavad Gita there is karma only recommended. Somebody says dhyan, somebody says yoga, somebody says bhakti. But actually, Bhagavad Gita is meant for bhaktas. Bhaktosi, sathasi. Bhagavad Gita was instructed to Arjuna for his only qualification that he was a devotee of. Bhaktosi means sathasi. So, the whole Bhagavad Gita is a sense of Vedic knowledge. And the Vedic knowledge means to understand Krishna. Vidaisya sarvaya hami va vidya. Vidaisya dullava adur lava atma bhakto. Even if we study Vedic literature without bhakti, without studying the Vedic literature, you cannot understand the absolute truth. Bhakta sruta grihitaya tasadda dhanasya munayo jnana vairagya yuktaya tasadda dhanasya munayo. Those who are faithful, such great saintly person, sadda dhanasya munayo jnana vairagya yuktaya. Jnana vairagya yuktaya, there is sufficient knowledge and vairagya, detached. Vairagya, Vedanta knowledge is not to be discussed on the table as a recreation, taking tea and smoking and discussing on Vedanta Sutra. This kind of discussion is not held. Jnana vairagya yuktaya, vairagya. There must be detachment from material activities. Tasadda dhanasya munayo jnana vairagya pasanti atmani atmanam bhakta sruta grihitaya. Bhakta, there must be bhakti. And what kind of bhakti? Not sentiment, but sruta grihitaya. Taking, accepting bhakti, the devotional path, after being completely aware of the spiritual science, vakta sruta grihita. Sruta, the specific meaning of sruta means this knowledge has to be received through the ear, through the tongue. Sevanamukihi jivhado sruta grihitaya. It is never explained in the Vedic literature that the science of God can be understood by the eyes. No. It has been mentioned, the tongue and the ear. These are the sources, sruta grihitaya. One must hear the Vedic literature. The Vedic literature is called therefore Shruti, Shrotriyam, Brahma Nishtham. Shrotriyam. Formerly there was no book. We students used to hear from the spiritual master. Sruta, Shrotriyam, That was perfect. There was no need of literacy. That ear is sufficient. Sutta Dhitaya, Tasuddha Dhana Samunayo, Jnana Vijayagutan. Hearing. One becomes enlightened with knowledge, and the effect of knowledge is vairagya. Vairagya, detachment. Otherwise, hearing or studying, but there is no vairagya. Even big sannyasis, they are in a saffron dress, but the vairagya, so far vairagya is concerned. If you study their inner history, there is no vairagya. They are attached to all kinds of material enjoyment. Simply a soap-bottle dress, that will not help. But there must be vairagya. That vairagya can be achieved by book, bhakta-srupa-vihipada. When you hear, bhakta means through the devotees, or you becoming devotee, that must be devotional sense. And bhakti means sevan-mukha, the attitude of rendering service to the Lord. That is bhakti. Rishikena rishikesa sevanam bhakti ruchyate. Bhakti means when you engage your senses for the service of the master of the senses, rishikesa, that is called bhakti. Bhakti is not sentiment. Just like these boys, these American, European boys, Indian boys, who are working for Krishna consciousness, they are simply engaging their senses in the service of the master of the senses, Krishna. Therefore, they are making progress. Rishikena rishikesa sevanam bhakti ruchyate. Sevana mukhe hi jivhado sayam eva spulattada. When you engage your tongue in the loving service of the Lord, he becomes revealed. He manifests himself. Ishara sarvabhutanam nirdesharjuna is already there within your heart. And if you become purified, tatparatena nirvanam, sarvapadhivinimuttam tatparatena nirvanam. If you become nirvan, if you become purified, how you can become purified? Tatparatena, just being absorbed in thought of Krishna, tatparatena nirvanam. If you simply remain always in fire, then you remain always one. There is no possibility of being caught by the chilly coldness. That is not possible. Vaividhisamamamaya-durattaya. Ma-me-mina-prapadnanti-maya-me-tantaranti. The only process for keeping yourself aloof from the touch of Maya is bhakti. Is bhakti. That is the conclusion of all shastras. Without taking to the process of bhakti, you cannot get out of the influence of Maya. That is required. That is the objective of life. Gyam jnanagammam. So, if we utilize our life for understanding the Supreme Gyan, Jnanagammam, Mahicha Ananda-jugena, Bhakti, if you learn that art, how you can become Ananda-juga Bhakti, a Vyabhicharini Bhakti, then you will understand what is Krishna. Vaktanamabhijanati javanjasyami taptata. By tapta, by improve, you will be able to understand Krishna. And as soon as you understand Krishna, your life becomes successful. janma padmam me vibham dhija anati tattva. So the same tattva in truth, not superficially. If you understand Krishna, then tattva deham punar janma naiti. After giving up this body, you will not have to accept another material body. That is samsiddhim paramangata, that is highest perfection of life. If you don't accept anymore the material form of body, there are 8,400,000 species of body. Any type of body you accept, it is troublesome, it is miserable. Matras varsartu kaunteya siddhasna sukhudukhada. The bodily pains and pleasure are perceivable. Matras varsartu, because we have got this material skin, matta. And when it is in touch with the influence of this material world, matras varsartu, it becomes subject of pains and pleasure. But if you don't have this material body, then you are untouched by the material qualities. You are completely in spiritual body. So there is no question of pains and pleasure. It is simply blissful life. Māmupetta-tukantiya dukkhālayava sāsatam lāpnuvanti mahātmāna saṁsiddhīṁ paramānandatā. That is the highest perfection of life. If you come back, if you go back to home, back to God, Krishna. So this is the process.
We shall discuss tomorrow.